we're going to go there and talk about theoretical physics, well, then I'm going to say, well, maybe that's not the limit. Maybe Saitama could be even more powerful. Maybe he could destroy the... If you're new around here, my name's Dylan. I just put a PhD in physics on hold to create some fun things, and AI My Cars is now out. You just take a picture of your car, you chuck it in my website, and you can turn it into a supercar, a muscle car. It's a lot of fun, so come check it out. Anywho, let's get into this video. I am so keen for the new One Punch Man season later this year.
Some of my very favorite episodes to do come straight from you guys. Follow me on Twitter to suggest what episodes I should do today. And today, I am tackling the topic that's maybe suggested to me the very most. How strong is One Punch Man? Well, I think I know how strong he is, but more importantly, I think I've figured out how strong he could possibly be. One Punch! One Punch Man took an interesting path to anime.
So I've actually made a couple videos on One Punch Man already, all right? I'll talk about them after, but I did a couple calculations. I quantified how strong this man is.
It was a webcomic, and then a manga, and then it went to series. The protagonist, Saitama, is basically the strongest being in the universe, able to defeat any opponent with just one punch. The character is a satire of sorts, and I think that's why we love it, but if you're the strongest hero ever, how strong is that? Every explanation that I have seen bases Saitama's powers off of this anime intro, specifically that his fist is going so fast that it can heat up the air around it like a space shuttle re-entering Earth's orbit, kind of like this, or like this. I have a new editor. I'm just testing him. Anyway, these explanations also mistake force for energy and use blue shifting and red shifting when I think it's not really acceptable. So let's abandon this reference point and look to what we can actually see happening in the anime to find the true limit of Saitama's strength. First, a direct speed comparison. In a fight with one of his strongest foes, Lord Boros, he gets punted to the moon. And then after checking out how cool reduced gravity is, he jumps back. If the moon is 384,000 kilometers away,
I did this calculation as well. So is this the only one?
Time between Saitama's jump and his landing, at least in the anime, is around 9 seconds. That means he has to move at least as fast as 43,000 kilometers per second. That's 14% the speed of light. Astrophysicist Ethan Siegel.
That's okay with me.
Helped me a lot on this episode, also estimates that based on Saitama's mass and size, he would be pulling trillions of G's and putting trillions of atmospheres worth of pressure onto the moon's surface. At least that explains this scene. Science! Saitama only gets more impressive from here. Abrupt fire punch! Nice. That's how fast Saitama can be, but how strong is he? Or rather, how much force can one of his punches provide? In this scene, OPM stops a meteor with just one punch. But to do this physics-wise, he would have to dissipate all the kinetic energy of that meteor over the distance.
We did this one too.
Of his fist. Kind of like what happens when a car crumples around a tree. If the meteor is a city killer, let's assume it to be a cube-ish thing with 60 meters on each side, the density of rock, and a velocity of 17 kilometers per second.
That's the average.
If all the kinetic energy wrapped up in this meteor comes to a stop within maybe half a fist's distance, or 3 centimeters, then the average amount of force that a one-punch man punch can pack is 3 quintillion newtons. That's a big, big number, but maybe it's easier to understand if you think of it like 90 billion Saturn V rockets taking off from your face. Woo! That may be how strong Saitama is, but we've never seen his full potential. What is the real physical limit of his strength? The strongest a punch from One Punch Man could possibly be is one not that destroys every foe, but everything. I asked Ethan Siegel about this too, and there is a punch so serious that it could restart the universe. The universe as we know it only exists because it's period.
Have they done that in the manga yet? That's, if that hasn't happened, we all know that's coming.
Of inflation, I mean, or the instant has. Where inflation, or the instant where the universe went from almost nothing to, well, everything stopped. If we could.
Well, we don't actually know if that inflationary period stopped. It might have continued on beyond what we can see, beyond the observable universe. And a lot of people suspect it might have, and the universe might be much larger beyond the observable little region we can see.
Somehow restart inflation, then the universe would begin to push itself apart again to the point that even atoms would rip. What kind of punch would that take? One where every particle in Saitama's fist has the energy to create inflation-related particles, like some hypothetical giant atom smasher, and thus restart cosmic inflation. So if you estimate the number of particles in Saitama's fist and give them all a physicist-recommended 10 to the 32 giga electron volts, then one universe-destroying punch would have the energy of 1,000 gamma ray bursts. Some of the most energetic events in the universe, or all the energy from all the thermal energy from all the particles in the sun in just your hand, in just one fist. So the strongest Saitama could possibly be, the punch wouldn't look like this. It would look something like this. Oh, oh no! That is the ultimate limit of a One Punch Man punch.
I should also add here, this really depends on inflation being a thing. So it is a hypothesis. There's not that much evidence for it at all. There are vast uncertainties with all of these things in cosmology because it's all on shaky ground. So inflation, did it happen? Well, we really don't know. It looks like it might have. And then if inflation continued, right, who knows how big the universe really is. And what happens if the universe is infinite in size? It might be. If this does say inflation is a thing, right? And then, but the universe is also like infinite. That might not be the end. Him, he can already survive a vacuum, Saitama. So who's to say he can't survive the bulk? Yes, I'm going to theoretical physics territory. So it's like, you know, there are potentially things outside our four dimensions of space-time, three spatial dimensions, one temporal dimension, the bulk, which is like the background higher dimensional space-time, right? Whereas like we're in like this brain, which is like this embedded 3+1 dimensional time-like hypersurface in that bulk thing. We assume we live on like one of these brains, right? You know, this is straight out of theoretical physics, of course, but inflation is still very much theoretical as well. If we're going to go there and talk about theoretical physics, well, then I'm going to say, well, maybe that's not the limit. Maybe Saitama could be even more powerful. Maybe he could destroy the bulk, the higher dimensional space-time, which is like all of the dimensions, if such a thing is even real. So here we are again, not knowing how strong Saitama is. And I can't help you with figuring out how to destroy the brain. That's beyond me. You're going to have to go talk to that guy over there who wrote that book, Kip Thorne, Nobel Prize winner. You might be like, well, how would he survive outside of our space-time? Time doesn't exist in space. Well, hey, he was on the moon. Fine, all right, so who am I to say he couldn't exist out there either? Maybe he's God. But really, there is a limit, right? Which is, if the universe is infinite, well, then I guess he's doesn't have a limit. He has an infinite limit, which means there is no limit. And if one, the author of One Punch Man, is out of ideas for Saitama and like where to take him, because they've kind of reached the limits of probably everything they've heard of, right? So, well, here you go. There's some ideas in theoretical physics. You can take Saitama even further. We have not reached the limits of our imagination just yet. I want to see Saitama destroy the bulk.
Granted, these energies are so big that we don't know if the laws of physics break when you get to them. Although, the laws of physics are already broken in anime, so I think we're okay. Plus, the real strength of Saitama doesn't come from physics, it comes from satire. As long as there are beefy superheroes spouting exposition to each other, Saitama is going to be there and stronger than them. So, by definition, he's already stronger than Superman and the Incredible Hulk. Because science, fiction writing.
That was amazing. Can confirm Kyle Hill is a legend, and that Because Science is indeed correct here. I think that was all pretty well done.